Hi, it's Chad Smith, and this is my first time. First music I ever bought? Well, again, I'm pretty old, so 45s, and I started listening to music really young. And I think I saved up enough money for my little paper route or shoveling snow again in Michigan. Those are the jobs you had. And I bought a record called, no one probably has this, it's called The Groovy Grubworm. And this is probably 1968. I was probably 6 or 7 years old. My little 45 player to flip top. Put the nickel on the top of it so it doesn't skip. And of course, it had two speeds, 33 and 45. And it was by Harvey J and the Wilcox. And it was kind of a country-ish, wasn't really rock and roll. My dad really liked country music, so maybe that was part of it. But it was kind of a novelty song. It was all instrumental. But in the middle of the song, they had this break, and there was a drum break, and the doom 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 doom. Drummer, I like that. And then it would stop, and the only thing the guy said in the whole song was, I'm a grub worm. And then, and so I thought it was really funny to play it fast. I'm a grub worm. I'm a grub worm. I just wore that thing out. Yeah. Harvey Wilcox. I don't know where he is now. Gotta be dead. First car?
Yeah.
Wow. That I owned?
Yeah.
Would be General Motors Grand Safari, which was a big giant station wagon with the wood paneling on the side. And in the back it opened up, it seated probably 9. I don't know how I acquired the Grand Safari. One of our neighbors was discarding it. Ooh, well, we used to tour with the Foo Fighters a lot back in 99 and 2000. But in 99, we did a pretty extensive American tour with them. And I became very friendly with them. Spent most of my time in their dressing room before they would play, doing things that people do before they play. And I became really friendly with Taylor Hawkins, the drummer. So, as you know, the drummer doesn't move around. He has to sit in one spot when you're playing the drums. And so I decided it would be a good idea to like rig up things above him. And we would play like 3 weeks and take like 10 days or 12 days off. 3 weeks, 10 days, that was kind of our schedule. And at the end of every 3 weeks, I would, just because, you know, it's what you do to your friends while they're performing, like whether it was M&M's, big like giant, not like a few, not a bag, like a lot, thousands. And at the end of one of their songs, it would all come down on him and he couldn't get out of the way. I thought that was funny. And went to, you know, M&M's and popcorn and nothing dangerous, no knives or anything. So at the end of the tour we did with them, which was a couple of 3 months, I kind of knew that they were like, we don't care. We're just going to get Chad back, right? And they were smart about it. And it was like the second or third before the last show. And we're playing. And it was funny because we were filming for a DVD, a live DVD. And so it's on film somewhere. And I'm playing one of our songs towards the end. And down comes ping pong balls and glitter, I think it was. Which was kind of weird. It was okay, but it was kind of weird. And Dave and Taylor are on the side, and they're like, "Yeah," I'm like, "Fuck you!" And I'm playing, you know. And it's kind of a fast song. I remember. And Anthony's laughing. He's missing all the words because he's laughing. And then the ping pong balls and the glitter stopped. And I was like, "Okay, cool." And then, like 500 pounds of spaghetti, and that was like snakes falling on you, like, and for a long time. It did not stop, and it's all over the drum, the thing, and my arm, and they got me really good, and I barely finished the end of the song, I like run off and tackle Dave, and yeah, That was good. That was our fun. But we just had a lot of great fun with those guys and their buddies. Taylor's the godfather to one of my kids. Poor kid.